contest! Automated reloader, stealth weapons, and shield charge booster. We have, and I don't know why they're not where they need to be, but we have the boss ion, the boss laser, the boss missile, and the boss beam. They all take a very long time to fire. We're going to pretend to be the flagship and fight other ships. For now, the goal is keep these weapons for the entire run. That may change. Oh wow. Hello, I can't hear if you are talking. Why can't you hear me? You can hear me. My weapons are over in this area. Wow, I have a lot of power. 42 powers. I also have me on mute, so I can't hear me. This is some kind of mod. This is the Rebel flagship mod, where you fight with the Rebel flagship, which all of its weapons are off to the side over here. I'm not quite sure why. Okay, so I will let the chat room decide start playing. This is on easy, and this is a yes pause run, because I don't do no pause runs. Not yet, at least. Oh, we cloak your shot! The problem with that, I can't fit all that. Lord Rupert Eve. That's your character limit right there. Okay, but now you're just Everton. That doesn't sound right. Alright. By the way, I just wanted to wish everyone in the chat box a very happy birthday. Let's see what's in this nebula. In this nebula is the end of the game. Oh. And we cannot continue. Well, that's not cool. Well, why don't we start over? No nebulas for us. It's not your birthday. Well, I thought we had the same birthday. You and me and everyone else in the chat room. I think there is a bug in the software where anything over 30 bars of power, if you jump into an ion nebula, it just kicks you out of the game. Well, usually you can load right back up and just not go to the... I will accept their bribe. And it will not go into the... Just don't go into the... on the flag on my cell phone, because when it uploaded the video, it wasn't high enough resolution just yet. I already turned down the game volume. Just turns itself right back up. But it's going to turn itself back up, though. Okay, sure. Move, go. It's much, much lower than an idle microphone sound on OBS. I can't even hear my jumps at all. That's as low as we can go. I'm probably gonna win. Will you win this time? That's the question. The game is too loud right now. It's not, I mean, I can barely hear it. I read it on the internet, I just couldn't read it. Like, I read it on my laptop. I couldn't read it on my phone. And by the way, I'm working on developing a cure for cancer. It's like whenever I stream, it's just really bad sector layouts. I would love the clone bay, but I've test ran the ship before, and it doesn't actually give you a clone bay. You just, it takes your scrap, leaves you high and dry. Let's attack. Developing what? I don't understand the question. Why don't we try to get a crew kill? Why didn't I think of that before? I said I'm developing something. I don't know. I'm not developing anything. I'm developing a crew kill here. Oh, when I said I'm trying to develop a cure for cancer? Is that what you're talking about? I'm working on it. Yes! More scrap. Yes, I will rescue the store. How come you don't have the full weapon rooms like the first stage Rebel flagship? Because whoever modded this didn't mod it that way. They also put these icons over here instead of where they belong, as I've said twice before. Let's go to Mantis Control, because those are really easy to fight. I guess we can just... I mean, I don't really see the point of using this flagship when it gives you all the power you ever need at the very beginning. I don't mod mods, I download mods, and use mods. Distress. First laser, Mark 1. Okay. But I can give myself some more evasion. pretty sure I had enough already. But at least now when I cloak, I'll be over 100%. It would be time for me to learn to mod if I wanted to do that. I just don't want to. Oh, I was hoping they'd get the kill there. And the beam doesn't penetrate shields! No! Alright. I mean, I guess we could just try to race through since we don't really need to collect scrap with this mod. Or we could try to get better weapons. We could try to race through or try to get better weapons. That's taking me way out of the way. It's a trap! Anything but a trap! Don't die! Oh, there's more to fight. I thought someone died. Jason. Did I test your super OP ship yet? Hey, how dare you shoot me, rebel fighter? Do you know who I am? Do you know who's on board? You just shot at the Lord Rupert Everton. Oh, you're in for it now. You shot again? Yeah, you better miss. Yes, I magically found your super OP ship out of thin air, and I tested it. Do you have a mod somewhere out there I'm just teasing, Jason. Gosh. Jason Banks. There, you get to be this guy. The only other mods are ship mods I've used. One is an automated scout, and you can't, as far as I know, you can't have any crew on it at all. So you don't need oxygen, you don't need doors, you don't need a med bay. And another one is called the Potential or something like that. And it gives your reactor 60 bars of power or something like that. And then, but it gives you like barely any shield, barely any engine. You know, it gives you the bare minimum, and you have to earn all the scrap to build your ship up, but you never have to upgrade the reactor. Destroy and loot the ship, they're just pirates. These boss weapons are really, really slow. And I fell for that trap, and now we get to dive after this quest. Yeah, let's dive. Oh, no, you didn't. Why don't we send a boarding drone also? We can let the boarding drone take care of business over there. Good job, we got a whopping 24 scrap and a store. I would love to get that clone bay. We may end up using a burst laser one later on. Yes, I know, you're Lord Rupert Everton. I get it. Let's take the shields down, and then take down the clone bay, and I want to take this missile down. And then we can teleport and fight. Try to get a crew kill. Well, obviously none of the crew are named Michael Skarn, because I haven't named any of them Michael Skarn. Any other easy questions? No, I could do that. Yeah, I'll fight him one at a time. I have no problem with that. crew kill on a dive. I could name one Michael Scarn right now. You'll have to wonder if it's Michael Scarn or Catherine Zeta Scarn. Next sector. Let's avoid this abandoned sector and go fight some Zoltans. Okay. I mean, how OP do you need it? I know the game's challenging, but it's not that hard. One health? One health? That was a tough fight. Enough to be casual run. Enough to be a casual run on hard setting. Don't you think that's a little excessive? Kind of like this flagship? Why don't you stream it sometime? Do you ever stream that ship, Jason? Do you have any YouTube videos of any streams with it? I will never submit to profiling. Parts get here on the 16th. My shields! No! They're down to level 3. Oh, that's better. I didn't learn until quite recently that when you kill a Zoltan, they kind of explode and cause, I think it's 15 points of damage. Let's hail them. A Zoltan ship comes out of nowhere. Oh, that's a lot of damage. Oh. I'm fighting a lot of Zoltan ships because I went to a Zoltan-controlled sector. Nope, I'm not in Mantis Homeworlds. And I can prove it. Really? They're not gonna fight the border drone? That's fine. I don't know how I missed this med bay here. Yes, Zoltan controlled sector. Is that a heavy pierce? That pierced four layers of shields? That doesn't sound right. How did they get that attack in there? How did it happen? I need to know! Alright, I'm just gonna get out of this sector. I'm gonna try to get through these sectors a little quicker. Hey, I need my shields. No. We're gonna race through here and try to kill ourselves at the end, but we can stop at a store. Not ourselves, the other flagship ourselves. It'll be like a mirror. Why don't we buy fuel just in case? I mean, we have 14, but I don't want to take any chances running out of fuel. I don't want to fight any rockmen for crew kills. 3, 4. And I have to avoid the nebula in case there's an ion in a nebula, and then that'll cause the game to crash. Yeah, I don't want to. I want to go quick, but I don't want to skip any fights. Yeah, let's outrun them. They're too slow. I don't think I've ever gone through a sector this quickly. Come on, guys, heal up. Oops. Wrong guys. I guess I didn't leave them in there long enough. Oh, storm! I'm trying not to out-stupid myself. And I'm failing. Yes, of course. Let's investigate intelligent life. Let's bring them on board to sell them. And let's lose Jeff Lagarde. Alright, we're gonna go pirate so we can get two more sectors that are green. Because I don't want to deal with Zoltans again. Because it takes an extra like 18 seconds to kill them. I can't upload a video because it doesn't like OBS, but I'm gonna upload it to my account. Fair enough. Okay, I don't think they can do it. Oh, I just saw that. So we have 5 health, but I thought this was lower. It's actually not that low. No, I'm not going to accept surrender. What do I look like? Ryan! 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 We're going to rename Ryan. And I know that you know exactly what I'm going to name it. Yeah, link the ship. Okay, so the temp is gonna be, I think the temp and Dwight are a good team. Okay. Let's see if I can't fix that. Okay, try linking again. I know, I always forget. It should be enabled. Links should be enabled. Links should be enabled now. That is totally my bad. And I feel really bad about it. Okay, now I don't know what to say because links are no longer disabled. I don't have Nightbot. Let's get an old-fashioned kill here. Oh, he hit two of my misses down. Okay, let's get a new fashion kill. Come on, shields guy, fix the shields! Amount of fuel and scrap. I'm gonna go paste this virus here and see what happens. Server not found. I don't even know what you're implying, or should I say infer? Ryan used me as an ob. I don't believe in .coms. Oh, now I know what you meant when you said they're gonna take the .com off. Because I was thinking, I don't know what that means. Yeah, I think I was trying to say that. What did I say? Oh, I said Ryan used me as an, and then my voice completely just died on the word object. Temp used me as an object. Yeah. Look, it says It says, we recently came across some extra drones. But they're holding out. They're only giving me one drone? No. It's not that I trailed off, it's that I lost my voice for one word. I can't avoid the nebula, it might kick me out. No! It's part of this ship. I started with 42 power. And it's not any nebula, it's only the nebulas that have ions. It doesn't always happen. But if this one doesn't work, this is gonna be stream. Maybe not. Maybe I'll try streaming a different one. No! I'm That seems to be what fixed it last time. Heavy laser Mark One. I like it. I know there's a delay, but I need like instant feedback on game volume, because when you guys say it's loud, that's not coming through on my end, so I can make any changes in the volume. I don't like this boss ion. I'll let you guys decide if I should stick with the original four weapons, or if I can start substituting burst lasers and heavy lasers and other weapons I find acceptable. I don't know if I'll use it, but I'll get it. I mean, I could try to teleport, but then I'd have someone I don't want. Now, this is kind of funny, I think. Send a boarding drone, and it'll damage the shield. Okay, it will not damage the shield. Never mind. It did when I did it before. Maybe it didn't. Hey, don't bomb me with your ion bomb or whatever it is. Well, maybe I should have waited and missiled it first. Well, if I had to take one, I guess I could take another Mantis. Now that I've sent the really, really slow guy all the way down to sensors, I can make him take the long, lonely walk of loneliness back up to the midday. Boarding drone fail. I hope you sounded like that when you said it. Boarding drone fail. Good luck, Distress, and see you later. Oh, come on, man. Well, it's been fun, guys. I'll see you around. No way! Boarding drone, you went to the wrong spot. Blogs are out right now, but people are texting still. Okay, let's see if I can't be intelligent here. I can wait till piloting's down completely. Okay. Take down the shields. Keep working on the shields. Alright, now let's take down. Make sure we get weapons down. No more missiles. Yeah. That went pretty well. So when I slow down and think just a little bit, yeah, this ship is really overpowered. Store! Cool, man, look at all that great stuff. I think I'm gonna keep. I'm gonna keep these weapons. I I might switch some of those back. Store! Give me a couple of flak ones and a couple of burst laser twos. Combat to you. I could try something like that. Biology beckons. Oh, you guys are fine. Yeah, you guys are fine. Yeah, you got 3 health left. Why complain? Come on up. My dog is so stupid. I love you, stupid dog. But you are stupid. Let's see. Okay, so when we do get to the flagship, I'm going to try to get some crew kills going down. So because Kirkner has a decent amount of fighting experience, we'll be sending him and the temp along with Dwigd and Pomeroy. Roy Anderson, what did you miss? You missed about 8 or 9 good fights. You missed one fight, I think. Alright, let's jump. The Last Stand. What is the meaning of this? Who are you? Blah, blah, blah. Risk none or save all. Risk all or save none. I wish I had hacking. Come on, fire, keep lasting. That didn't do any good. Okay, now I should take them shields down. Okay, you can burst laser one it down the rest of the way. Okay, we can heavy laser one it down the rest of the way. Okay, we can burst laser one, maybe? That thing takes a lot of damage. Try again for the mohole. I mean, I may as well, right? It's highly unlikely that I run into a store. Oh look, a store! It's gonna sell me something I want for 95 scrap. I'm in the reverse ion field, could help. In case you didn't know, it protects my ship from ion damage, giving a 50% chance to negate it entirely. And in case I need the parts, yeah, I've seen speedruns of FTL that are something like 12 minutes long. We can just go there. Let's play the cloaking game. We both cloak at the same time! Actually, let's not do that. Oh, that's pretty much perfect. Where I wanted the boarding drone to go into one of those isolated rooms. And I'm gonna send, my plan is to send, you know, cause the Mantis will win the fight and then destroy the weapons. So send a Mantis here, and then they can fire at me with ions all they want, but I have a 50% chance of evading that. What I normally like to do with hacking is, a lot of people say hack the piloting, I like to hack the shields instead. And that isolates piloting, and then I usually, like if I have mind control and hacking, which I usually do, I can bring the shields down with the hacking and then fire all my weapons at the shields, mind control the pilot so nothing misses, and then they'll just send people into shields all the time, over and over. Oh, Steven! You took a nasty blow to the head. And I think I'm a little late on that cloak. Anyways, yeah, people will go in and try to fix the shields, and that's when I get a lot of crew kills. He's back up, ready to go. Cloak? Why would you cloak? Okay. You're next, buddy. You're next, Dwigged. Hey Duke, how's it going? As you can see, Duke, we have a little modification going on. We are fighting the flagship with the flagship. That's too many misses. The flagship is... it's kind of a ridiculous mod because you start off with 42 power, which is enough that your game will crash if you jump into the wrong nebula beacon. And you already have level 4 shields and like level 4 or maybe 5 or 6 even of engines. And level 2 of cloaking and teleporting. So you can't really get any other systems. Okay, let's teleport here. And I don't know if that'll change their piloting or not, but... Alright, we got a few good shots in there. Yeah, die from the fire! Okay, let's send our other fighters. Maybe we can just send some more crew members aboard. Take down their cloaking? I don't know. Maybe we won't do that. Let's bring these guys back instead. Nice! Way to get the kills, guys. And I want these fires to get some more kills, too. That's alright. Duke and Captain Kirk will be laser beam. Or we'll just go with laser. Thanks for the knife shots compliment. That was after a bunch of poor shots. So we are going to try to take down their missiles right away with our teleporters. I'll just let him go, nice and slow. I should have put my defense 2 up right away. I did not do a good job with that either. Oops, just the one guy, come on. All right, boarding drone. Great, great job. I like where you're targeted. There's only one mod, it's the flagship mod. So, yes, mods. I don't like the fact that I have no shields. So now is as good a time as I need to cloak. Alright, let's try to get these guys down. No, he get anywhere in there. Maybe we could take down... their drones. Well, let's just take down weapons. That's not doing what I wanted to do. That's a lot better. But Steven is down. He's been down for a while apparently because he's ready to come back. Okay, why don't we try to finish them off? Because I don't want this crew member to die. We don't want the AI. Can you come heal up? Can you come heal up? Yeah. This flagship is very overpowered. So this is about what you start with. Level 4 shields, I think 4 or 5 engines, and then 2s across the board. You start with the teleporter and the cloaking. And you start with the boarding drone and the defense too. And you start with 42 bars of power. And then I think your doors are level 1 or 2. And these aren't very high, but I don't recall. And that's at the very beginning, so... And you get all their weapons, although they put them up in a corner here for some reason. But I did sell the ion weapon and installed some weapons, I think in Sector 6. I kind of just raced through like 3 or 4 sectors. The problem is these weapons take a long time. The boss beam takes 26 seconds, the laser is only 20. I say only 20. The missile's 23, and the ion was 28 seconds. If you fire them all, like set them all to fire at the beginning, the ion will be the last to fire. Which I feel like it should fire sooner, but... Why don't we go to the store and heal ourselves? Oh, I feel so much safer now. I was really worried, but now that we've got our hull maxed out, I'm feeling pretty good about it. Well, we won't have the base to jump back to now, but that's okay. If things go wrong, we'll have to deal with it. See, this is where I would like to have mind control, but you can't buy any systems with this ship. We'll stop fighting each other so much. Want to see a hilarious boarding drone fail? It's in the fail blog! Boom. If I get this guy over here, can I teleport him? I was late. Okay, stop controlling my mind. It's my mind. My mind. Power surge detected? No, what am I gonna do? How am I gonna avoid a power surge? Oh, I guess I can just cloak. Okay, why don't we take him down? Ha! Now you can't heal yourself, guy. Legs. Why did he even register for Twitch? It took too long. And now the crew's dead. Yeah, hacking would be nice because the first flagship has hacking. So why can't I have hacking, right? Yeah, I really like when I fight the flagship. I don't care if I have drone control. It's nice to have the hull repair or whatever. I really like having mind control at level 1 and hacking, and I will hack the shields and then mind control the pilot. And when the shields are all the way down, then I just fire everything at the shields and take them down. And no one can get to the pilot, right? So I'm not going to miss anything. And then everyone, they'll break through the doors and they'll try to fix the shields. And then I'll just keep shooting at the shields and I'll get all my crew kills that way. That works out really well for me. I've only played on hard one time thanks for the GG. I only played on hard one time since my first win. I think I had 80 hours logged in FTL before I had my first win on easy, because I just didn't get it, like how to play well. And I did not make it to the flagship. I only play Advanced Edition, though. If you want to see, without mods, people killing flagships on hard, there is a guy that you should watch. Because he is currently on his 51st or 52nd fight, and he plays only on hard, and he plays every ship, every version of every ship. And he's lost one time, and he has 51 wins. Billy One Curtain. He's unbelievable. And he streams for... oh gosh, he probably streams 6 days a week. on average, like 3.5 to 4 hours. He streams a lot. A lot. And he's really nice, and if you don't understand what he's doing, just ask and he explains, all polite-like and everything. So these are some of our stats. He's not streaming right now, that's why I am. Most scrap collected, 4,314. So there's a mod I used called Disable Fleet, and so you can go to every single beacon in every sector except for Sector 8, and so you can get at least 4,314 scrap from that. 2,384. Oh, that's so low. But I mean, there were some sectors in there where I think I had 5 jumps to get through the sector, because what's the point when the ship's already overpowered? So this mod takes the Slug A and turns it into the Rebel flagship. I have a mod that turns the Kestrel A into an automated drone. In fact, I could probably bring up I can bring these up. So let me close out of the game and I'll bring it right back up in just a second here. Show you these mods. And the first thing I'm going to try to do is to fix the sound, because the sound acts all funky. Turn it way up and then turn it way down. Hopefully that's not too bad. So yeah, this is called Potential, and it gives you something like 60 bars of power. And I think they took away the nebula location so your game won't crash. But you get, you know, hardly anything, and you have to earn all this crap. If you want a nice, fun, pretty easy playthrough, use this accompanied with Disable Fleet, and you can go to beacon after beacon, earning a lot of scrap and maxing out the ship. Otherwise, I forget where the automated scout is. Interesting. It might be this one here. I'm gonna close out and try that again. Auto scout. There it is. You get a couple of basic lasers, some repair drones, anti-personnel drones, and hull nanobots, which very, very, very slowly repair breaches and repair systems. I don't know how slowly they repair breaches, but they repair systems a lot slower than the system repair drone does. But I will stop with FTL for the night. And I'm going to switch it up to Kerbal Space Program. I'm working on a design for some kind of advanced probe in Kerbal Space Program that I'm going to introduce in the story in career mode later on, but I'm trying to design it in sandbox mode. And so I'm hyper editing its orbit. I don't really know what I'm going to do with it though. I don't know how I'm going to implement it in the story. Wow, 31 posts. That's a lot. And I'm liking everyone. Hurry up, Kerbal Space Program. Recruit the Kerbals. Recruit them. Let me know if the game volume is too loud for this. It might just be a FTL thing. Because on my end, the volume was always just fine. Never had any problems, so SSTO to Titan. What makes this probe advanced? This probe is advanced because it's going to use advanced technology that has not yet been unlocked in my career file. And I can't show you in the tech tree, but just things that are much further on the tech tree. Maybe it could have a warp drive on it. Maybe we can call it a non-functioning warp drive that someone will discover. But say they just didn't have enough battery power for it. And then a Kerbal will spot it and recover it and that'll be how they unlock the technology to get back home. So we're going to call this test. Test probe. Okay. Let's see. Come on, mouse. I'm having mouse lag. I did not have mouse lag in FTL. I just realized that, so that's a good sign. I did capitalize probe. It just didn't take. I must have let go of shift before. Ooh, warp drive. And you can see the warp bubble. And we all know what happens inside a warp bubble, right? Dr. Crusher argues against the computer. With the computer. She argues with Captain Picard. Why is it just the two of us on the ship? Two was all we've ever needed. What are these? Vault Trials. Okay. So let's say that some alien race had built this and put it in orbit, and they forgot solar panels somehow. And so now the battery's dead. What are they gonna do? At least it was Crusher and not Pulaski. Pulaski wasn't the worst, but she was pretty bad. Alright, so we have an SSTO to orbit. And now our orbit's even higher. And now why don't we orbit the sun? Okay, now why don't we make some more distance around the sun here. What is this? What is that? Oh, I know what that is. That's the first test I had. And maybe we can get out even farther. Oh, we went too far. Okay, now why don't we see if we can't orbit Jupiter? Oh, we're really close to Jupiter. Oops. There we go. Where's Titan? Titan not around Jupiter? Oh, I went to the wrong place, didn't I? I don't even know my solar system very well, do I? No, that's Triton. It's probably Saturn. Of course it's Saturn. Why wouldn't it be? Why don't we just go straight there? Above the sphere of influence? No, not Jupiter. How did I get to be so bad at the solar system? Well, it's probably because I didn't eat my vegetables when I was studying for solar system class in grade school. Come on, mouse lag, stop being so mouse laggy. I can use like the little track screen. Saturn doesn't even have rings. What kind of terrible mod is this? I haven't heard of Iapetus. Is that how you pronounce it? Because that's how I pronounce it. Alright, why don't we bring this orbit in closer? Oh man, my mouse is not acting cool at all right now. Yeah, okay, I don't want to be inside the atmosphere. No, I don't want to be inside. How big is this atmosphere? Alright, I have an idea. Why don't we make a plane? A big plane. A big space plane. With big tanks. Let's give it some turbojet engines. You could probably give it wings. My mouse is not, it's not cool right now. I'm not sure if that's really attached. I feel like it is okay. We'll pretend this is a good design. Yeah, we could have the big four on board. Gotta have the snacks though. Lame. And what am I missing besides landing gear? Well, those are humongous. I could scale it up too. I'm probably going to need yes, cue that. That's what she said, Jerix. No, I really could make it bigger though. Of course it will fly. I'll edit everything to make it fly. Well, first of all, you should never try to resist a that's what she said joke. And that's only my opinion, but it is true. Good enough for now. Now I know what you're thinking. This probably won't fly. I don't want it to explode. I want to edit it. I wanted to edit it. Should probably put it on some launch clamps. Can I just do it from here? Okay, let's put it on launch clamps first. Looks like another entry for the fail blog! Okay, so that's too... That's not good. I don't know where the atmosphere starts here. Will jets work on Titan? Yes, they will. When you give it oxygen. Now we're in the atmosphere. So it looked like it said its atmosphere was at 600 kilometers. That's a lot. I guess I could have just pressed the gear button. Okay, we could also try, let's quick save just in case. The lander, we can just land. Oh, we don't want to land on Earth, don't we? I should have put lights on this thing. And this is the easiest way to land a plane on Titan. Alright, let's not land. Let's just put it like at 150 kilometers. Let's put it at like 70 kilometers. 70 kilometers, I say. You're gonna have to put a second page on your fail blog. And I want to make sure we have oxygen. Okay, we do. I don't know if these numbers are good or not. We don't have any air intake. This is taking too long! And we are upside down! Why is it exploding? We're gonna try this one more time. Not 30 meters. You know what they say, fifth fail is a charm. All the cool people fly upside down when they fly in Titan's atmosphere. Oh yes, of course I should activate my engines. It seems like we might be a little top heavy. Alright, so what we can do is make like a realistic kind of plane instead of something humongous. I mean, the plane is not a security threat, it doesn't need to be that large. So we can try something nice and easy. Too many parts here. Okay. Hey, you know, at least the last one wasn't really a fail. It just didn't seem to be very fun. We are going to pretend like I know what I'm doing here. Okay, let's put some gear on this thing. Close enough for me. And we should probably put a solar panel on it. Come on, mouse. Give me my mouse back. We're going to use the pre-cooler for fun. Plane test. Get it? Plane? Get it? Do you understand the joke? All right, who wants to fly my plane? Maybe, but I think the center of lift is good where it is now, unless you made that comment before I moved it. I mean, it's not perfect, but it's a lot better. Who wants to fly? So the number of characters here affect whether or not it's a scientist or an engineer or a pilot. I don't really understand that, but that seems to be the case. Sorry, Duke, someone else had typed more recently than you had. Maybe it has a little too much power. I did not look at the thrust to weight ratio when I built it. I mean, we could change it. Good luck. And we are flying on Titan. It's a little darker here, but that's okay. Let's see if we can land. When we land, we can swap out pilots. I say that like we could actually land. Where else should we fly? Should we fly on Mercury or Pluto? I don't know if I can put... This flies really well. We could try to fly on Phobos or Deimos. Give it an ocean, why not? Give it an atmosphere with oxygen, why not? Oh gosh! Oh, the sphere of influence is less than 1 kilometer. But I took off crash damage. Didn't I give it? Oxygen? I thought I clicked it. Oops. I don't think I did that right. We only launched under 5 minutes ago. Duke, you will be flying. That's not what I want to do. Active vessel. Okay. I can't really seem to do that. So why don't we pick some other place? Where should we fly this plane? You decide! It's like a choose your own adventure book. Only it's not very interesting. You don't have to know how to fly. There we go. Oh, thanks for the birthday wishes. I thought we shared the same birthday. I'm not flying to Palmarineris. I'm not doing it. Choose. This is what I want you to do. Choose one of these, not the sun. I probably can't fly on a gas giant, although maybe we could try. But we'll pick one of these bodies, and we'll give it an atmosphere with oxygen, and we'll fly there. I'm not gonna go searching for landmarks on Mars. Jupiter already in it. No, that's dangerous. Jupiter. Let's give it an ocean. Let's give it, give it what it needs. Why are we exploding? Like, normally you could just land. Fine. I don't think we can. I think it's because it's a gas giant and it's just humongous. So we'll try Callisto. Okay, now let's do a save so I don't screw it up. Okay. Bad. really do anything. I can't activate my engine. Because I don't have anyone inside. Why? I thought I put Duke in there. Did I just edit Duke and forget to put him inside? See, it didn't add. I'm blaming that on mouse lag. Why is 1,000 meters altitude? Oh, because that put me 100 centimeters underground. I forgot to save. I wasted 53 seconds. 53 seconds. Go, I should name it the Challenger, because it keeps exploding. Let's do like 2 kilometers. Why would I go to Io? We haven't really done anything at Callisto yet. Can't see. Why is it? Did I not give it oxygen? Let's make these numbers closer to 1. Stop. Oh, I thought I did 20. There. I was like, we're still too high. Okay. That's a very, very low atmosphere. 0. All right, Duke. It's time to land. The gravity's so low here. All right, we'll see you later, Duke. Oh, you weren't kidding. You really were gonna go, Duke. I thought you meant like you're going to bed or something, but I guess you were just leaving the plane. Well, you gotta do what you gotta do. All Alright, we can go to IO. First, let's make it a place we can actually go to which we can actually go. Give it an ocean, an atmosphere, oxygen. Let's give it 31. Of course it's dark. Why wouldn't it be dark? Why can't we be on the other side of the IO? Come on, man. See how easy it is? Quick save. Up, up, and away. Oh, and they changed their name back. Why? Don't need much acceleration or thrust at all. Because we don't need a thrust weight ratio greater than one with these wings. Is Sig the same? I kind of wish I could actually change crew members mid-flight. But what we can do, if I don't totally shoot it, is we can land and then change crew members, theoretically. It's taking too long to descend. So if we make it go faster, we'll get lower sooner. Right? Where's Almathea? I did not see a shadow there. I was really expecting one. I was really expecting a shadow. Where's Almathea? Like that helps me. Man, know your audience. I don't think so. I don't think it's in this. You want to go to Europe? To be tidally locked? No. Let's give it more gravity. Fun with HyperEdit, right? Am I right? If we just aim for if we just aim for Jupiter, we can fly to it, can't we? Why don't we actually fly a rocket to Joule? I suppose I should land on one of these moons one time. And then we'll just take like a decent rocket and have it try to descend on Joule. We can give Joule an atmosphere and put a bunch of parachutes on something and it a huge heat shield. Just practice landing on Jupiter. I keep saying Jupiter. So what I need to pay attention to is altitude above the terrain. Because even though I didn't see the shadow on Io or wherever we were at last, I kind of glanced up and I looked through these numbers and then I saw this number hit zero and then I crashed. I guess it's possible I just missed the shadow, but I feel like I would have noticed it. Altitude above the terrain, that's when that hits zero, that's when we have landed. It's quite useful when you're trying to land without parachutes, with no atmosphere, any kind of ship. I don't think they gave Venus an atmosphere in this. Like, it has one, but I don't think it's drawn. Okay, there is a shadow. There probably was a shadow before then. So I look at my horizontal speed here, my altitude here. I don't need my nav bar. Coming in hot though. I mean, I was trying to pitch up, but I couldn't do it. Well, we couldn't land. Fail blog! Yeah, let's, I want to design something. We could try to land it on Venus. We can try to land it on, you know, Jupiter or Neptune or whatever. Okay, so let's do... bigger, and that's what she said. I know, we'll do it. That's what we call things. We call them what they are. Thank you. you don't see them, are they still there? Maybe.
Excuse me.
Yeah, we want oxygen. So if we do land, we can take helmets off and all of that. So let's put this at 500 kilometers. I don't think it rotates retrograde. If I give it a negative value, I guess so. It seems like it's rotating retrograde. Yeah, we'll go with that. This is going to be coming in pretty hot. Okay, we're gonna do a quick save and then we can quick load and then put it in orbit around like Jupiter and what are the other planets called again? Neptune's gravity multiplier is 1.14 compared to Earth. Are these realistic numbers? Those planets are a lot, maybe they're not more massive. I think they are though. They're a lot larger. wish I had made this heat shield a little bit bigger, but it should be fine. Maybe check Google. Yeah, I'm pretty tired as well. But I'm also not a quitter. Oh, we are really falling slowly. Let go. Get off of me. I don't want to hug you. I don't know how to change this number so that I'm lower. And I don't want to try the lander. Well, we could try the lander. Land! Wait. Why would it select Titan? I mean, I probably it's what I had selected most previously, but. Things are destroyed by heat because it's so hot. Look how bright things are. It's not that hot. I mean, it's pretty hot though. Good job, Bill. Way to somehow not die. Alright, we'll see you later then. I'm gonna try this at Jupiter though, because I do want to get more stupider. I mean, because I want to see what happens. Thanks for the GG. I'm gonna lower this down a little bit here. And I think it'll just do it on its own. Man, this heat shield will ablate away for sure. This is gonna take forever, but it really is the safest way. We have a landing gear outside the window. So this big gray thing, but if you look in the corner, we can see a little bit of Jupiter. Well, orbital velocity is 12.5 and our surface velocity is 7,000. That is a large difference. Heating is clipping through the ship. Excuse me. Okay. Why don't we try this again? I'm just gonna give it like a really big. I'll just give it the next level up, heat shield. I'll just make it really big. Will that work? No. That'll work. Okay, we're gonna orbit Jupiter again. And we're gonna do 8001. That is a good heat shield. Okay, now we want to bring down... Periapsis? I'm not sure. I want to kind of enter the daytime. I'd like our altitude to be lower. But yeah, this heat shield's a lot better. It might actually last this entire descent. Okay, that's a little more reasonable. We're not exploding. I'm not gonna mess with that. And remember, if you're watching this is just a little fun with HyperEdit. This isn't supposed to be realistic at all. Oh look, some kind of moon. Io probably? Possibly? Maybe? Our periapsis height is dropping at a reasonable rate. Don't mind that clicking sound you're hearing. All right, let's speed this up because this is taking way too long. That periapsis is dropping rapidly. Our altitude isn't really dropping so much. See, we're still, I mean, technically orbital. I know we're suborbital, really, because we're going to drop, but I don't know when the camera decides to switch there. Sets. Another one rose. This one now here. If I can turn around quickly, you can see this one's setting. We'll never see it again because we're all gonna die, even though we have crash damage disabled. No crash damage. Ignore max temperature, that's a good idea too. Ooh, excuse me. And our horizontal speed has dropped below 7 kilometers per second. 4 times physics acceleration, that's 28 kilometers per second for the viewer. Look at this heat shield. Let's make like a 10 or larger meter heat shield. You know what I wonder if I could do? I don't think the game is set up this way, but if I made this atmosphere depth so high, like 1,000 times higher, if I could get some of the moons to deorbit. Now we are dropping speed and altitude quite rapidly. I really thought this was going to ablate away completely. I was way off. Now the atmosphere is so thick.
How thick is it?
It's so thick that even at 300 plus kilometers, and it says there's no atmosphere, but even at 300 plus kilometers, now just under, we can basically just coast our way down. We went pretty far, it's kind of close to the night side. What's orbital velocity? Still 5 kilometers plus. Alright, sure, let's ditch it. That's right, we can have our parachutes fully semi-deployed at 233 kilometers. Altitude 5,000. Yeah, like we could ever reach 5,000. So we've given it an ocean, but I don't think it has an ocean. Copy to Kerbin. Time to periapsis is 11 and a half minutes, and that number is not changing. This is taking too long! Can't wait. So let's try altitude of 2. See, I don't think it's gonna work. we take its atmosphere away. We fall really, really fast. And we bring it back. Without our heat shield, we're gonna die, but we'll just get launched way through it. Alright. Well, that's enough of that. Switch back to FTL just to see this ship, this guy, this Jason guy had. See if it's really a virus. Don't think it's a virus. Wow! Reigniter, medbot, dispersal. I don't know where there's that, but okay. Apparently it's so powerful that it just kicks me right out of FTL. Well, maybe it is a virus. But it's way past my bedtime. I'm gonna stop streaming. Thank you people so much for watching. Thanks for watching on YouTube. We've lost 371 frames in 3 hours and 21 seconds. Until then, stay classy.